How's it going, everybody? Welcome back. And today we're going to be talking about Onion over VPN and why it's necessary for you to use a VPN with the Tor browser. Now, before we begin, if you guys are interested in any of the VPNs mentioned today, you'll find links to special deals and discounts in the description down below, as well as full reviews if you'd like to know the ins and outs of these VPNs in terms of privacy policy, speed streaming and torrenting capabilities, as well as security and features. So keep that in mind if you guys are interested. Now, when it comes to using the Tor browser itself, even without a VPN, it's still giving you a form of anonymity and privacy, which is quite good, but it's not exactly the type of privacy that you would be. It's not full scale privacy. And that's because of how the Tor browser really just works. The way it works is that while your information is going through three relays or three nodes, it's the entry node, the middle node, and the exit node, or relays, whatever you want to call them. So this is your computer, and when you're not using a VPN, you're essentially using your own IP address in order to enter into the guard or entry node. Now, of course, once you're in there and you're, you know, you pass through the entry node and you're into the middle node, you're completely, let's say, private and for the most part anonymous, okay? But since you're passing through the entry node using your, let's say, your PC or laptop or whatever device you're using, your ISP or your provider is going to be able to see what you're doing. Well, not what you're doing, is going to be able to realize that you're using your own IP address in order to enter the dark web. So they'll be able to tell that you're entering the Onion browser using your real IP address. So, you know, if you're in a censorship heavy country and maybe you're a whistleblower or a journalist or something like that, and your ISP notices that you entered the dark web and they realize that, oh, well, this guy, you know, this guy or girl used the their own IP address to enter the dark web, but now we can't see what's happening in the dark web. So let's go ahead and pay him a little visit, pay him or her a little visit, and see what they're doing on, you know, the dark web. So you don't want that kind of headache, especially if you're in a censorship-heavy country where these regimes don't really appreciate any kind of dissent, be it political dissent, social dissent, whatever it is. You know, what you're going to do, of course, you're anonymous, by the way. Your traffic is anonymous. They can never tell what's going on here, not in the middle relay or nor the exit relay. So, but unfortunately, they're able to tell that you use your IP address. So what you're going to do here is, of course, just use a VPN. And, you know, when you're using the Tor browser, keep that in mind. You are actually, your traffic, your browser traffic is secured and anonymized, but it's only your browser traffic. So anything outside of that browser traffic is not anonymized or secured or encrypted. So I don't know, maybe you're torrenting, maybe whatever it is you're doing outside of your browser is not going to be encrypted. This is also when a VPN comes in handy. Now, you know, some may ask, hey, why not use the Tor browser? You know, you enter the Tor browser and then the VPN. The thing about that is that, you know, creating a tunnel through the Tor network and connecting from there to your VPN service, also known as VPN over Tor, is more difficult to set up. For example, ExpressVPN does not support this method as it does not increase your anonymity. While this setup does make it impossible for the exit node to see your traffic, it is now the VPN service that is able to see your traffic again. In theory, a VPN that does not keep activity or connection logs can be trusted with this information, but it reintroduces an element of trust into an otherwise trustless setup, leaving you with no anonymity advantages, only the slow speeds of the Tor network, which is why it's, you know, much more recommended to actually use the Tor Onion over VPN, excuse me, instead of the VPN over Onion, because when connecting to a VPN first, then Tor, also known as Tor over VPN or Onion over VPN, gets you all the privacy protection of the Tor network plus added protection that prevents any Tor node from seeing your home IP address. You will also not have to worry about being flagged by your home network or ISP for using Tor, as all the ISP will be able to see is encrypted traffic to your VPN server. So Tor over VPN also provides access to the Tor network even where it is blocked, such as corporate and school networks or certain countries. Another advantage of Tor over VPN is that your VPN service will not see what you are doing inside the Tor network. And if there is a bug in the Tor browser, connecting to the VPN first will put an additional layer of security between that bug and you. So sometimes, you know, there might be bugs here and there within the Tor browser, and some information could perhaps leak here and there. The VPN will be an extra additional, let's say, layer of protection that will keep you protected no matter what happens. And of course, for the most part, most importantly, your ISP won't be able to tell what you're doing, neither will your VPN, because first of all, you have encrypted your data from your ISP using the VPN, and then you're using the Tor browser to encrypt yourself away from the, let's say, logs of the VPN, assuming that the VPN is logging your activity. Of course, I have three recommendations here that are known for having very let's say, reputable no log policies and privacy policies. So that's why I've got three recommendations here. Now that you know how to use the VPN with the Onion browser, of course, you know, as it's as simple as, let me bring it over here. You know, when you download the Tor browser, you're going to get a folder that looks like this. Okay. And all you need to do now is just turn on your VPN. And once your VPN is turned on, and just give it a few seconds here. And by the way, I'm using the lightweight UDP protocol with ExpressVPN just because it's the best performing protocol. You can definitely use OpenVPN UDP or TCP, but that will cut your speed by a lot. But yeah, I'd recommend either use lightweight UDP or OpenVPN UDP. I'll stick with lightweight. Once you're connected to your VPN, all you need to do is just log in to your Tor browser and you're good to go. That's it, really. It's as simple as that. And it's the best way to keep yourself protected from your ISP and just keep yourself private and anonymous in general. So now that you know, let's get into which one of these VPNs you might be choosing over the other. Now, there is ExpressVPN for starters, okay? And ExpressVPN is the VPN that I would recommend, especially if you're in a censorship-heavy country or if you're very, let's say, privacy-wary and you just want to keep yourself anonymous for one reason or another, definitely go ahead and use ExpressVPN. It's been audited multiple times, aced every audit, and every little error they have within these audits is addressed immediately. Not just that, we have a real life situation where ExpressVPN was tested in 2017 as part of the when the Turkish government actually seized an ExpressVPN server as part of an investigation over the assassination of the Russian ambassador back then. And the Turkish authorities were still not able to extract anything out of ExpressVPN. And really, that just gives you the ultimate evidence that ExpressVPN truly has a no-log policy, and they do really uphold the integrity of their privacy policy very well. So yeah, with ExpressVPN, especially if you're trying to unblock streaming services, by the way, ExpressVPN is definitely going to be the best one. Using Netflix as a reference, ExpressVPN is able to unblock up to 18 Netflix libraries. That'll be 10 with Nord and 15 with Surfshark. So this just gives you an idea of the reliability of ExpressVPN with regards to unblocking streaming services and Netflix. And then you've got NordVPN. Of course, all these VPNs, by the way, have the two basic features, which are the kill switch and split tunneling. And with regards to obfuscation, they all have very good obfuscation. But with ExpressVPN, the obfuscation is always on. And with regards to ExpressVPN's reliability in China, it's definitely the most reliable one. That's not to say that Nord and Surfshark don't work. They definitely work. But with regards to reliability in censorship-heavy countries such as China, ExpressVPN has the best record of reliability and consistency. Not just that, they also have an Onion website. So If you're not able to access ExpressVPN through the regular website for whatever reason, perhaps it's banned, you can access it through the Tor browser and download it from there. So that's also a plus. You know, they've got the people that are censored in mind. So yeah, ExpressVPN's definitely got your back in terms of privacy and anonymity. Now, NordVPN is the VPN that's a little bit cheaper, but still gives you plenty of options. First of all, you've got an ad blocker, the powerful NordLynx protocol, and kill switch, and an app kill switch. The kill switch, of course, if you didn't know, will disable your internet when the VPN disconnects unexpectedly. However, the app kill switch will disable or terminate applications, selected applications, when the VPN connection drops unexpectedly, rather than terminating your entire connection. You've got, of course, split tunneling, custom DNS, easy custom DNS options, and obfuscated servers will only be used if your regular servers don't work. Of course, the thing with NordVPN here with regards to Onion, the Tor browser, is that Onion over VPN will give you the ability to use the Tor or access the dark web without really using the Tor browser. I'll link this page in the description down below if you would like to configure your Firefox, for example, to access Onion websites. But, you know, the way I see it is that, and perhaps this could be useful if you're not able to download the Tor browser for whatever reason. Though, I mean, if you're going to download a browser or, you know, Firefox, let's say, if it's downloaded, you could definitely access the dark web through the Onion over VPN feature here with specialty servers. But if you're going to, if you have access to download browsers, you might as well download the Tor browser. It's going to be a better option, especially for your anonymity, because Firefox is not going to be as encrypted and as anonymous as the Tor browser. I mean, if you're using the, if you're trying to access the dark web in the first place, you're also probably seeking the anonymity and encryption that is offered by the Tor browser. So using Firefox or Chrome to access the dark web kind of defeats the purpose of that anonymity and the whole encryption thing going on with Tor browser. So I would definitely just recommend, it'll also be better and faster if you just use a regular server and then just access the Tor browser. Another thing that you get with NordVPN is that if you just here just switch to OpenVPN, you'll have access to two more specialty servers such as WVPN and dedicated IP. WVPN will route your connection through two servers rather than one if you are looking for double the encryption. If I didn't mention, by the way, ExpressVPN will allow you to secure up to 5 devices per subscription, 6 devices with NordVPN, and guess what? An unlimited amount of devices with Surfshark. And this is going to be one of the biggest selling points with Surfshark, besides, of course, also having plenty of features such as WVPN and dedicated IP, which are called multi-hop and static IP here. You also get, of course, the whitelister, which is split tunneling, the kill switch, and an ad blocker. What else do you get? You also get, you also get the powerful WireGuard protocol and a handful of protocols here that you might find useful. I would just stick to the WireGuard protocol. Another thing is that Shadow Socks will help you reach banned websites if they're banned for you. Though keep in mind, just like the Tor browser, this will only encrypt your browser traffic. So keep that in mind. No borders mode. It will allow you to bypass the Great Firewall of China if the servers or the firewall is not allowing you to access the servers. So this will kind of mitigate that. Now, of course, with ExpressVPN, you don't have to fiddle with anything to bypass the Great Firewall of China. And this is where the convenience and accessibility as well as ease of use come into place. But of course, if you're going to go with Nord and Surfshark, you might have to click a few more buttons here and there in order to set things up. And yeah, of course, this kind of accessibility and ease of use did cost money to kind of set up. So that's why you're gonna have to pay a little bit extra with ExpressVPN. But with Nord and Surfshark, that's not to say, of course, that they are not reliable. They are super reliable and great VPNs. Now, again, if you guys are interested in learning more about these VPNs, including advantages and disadvantages, please check the reviews below. You'll also find links to special deals and discounts if you're interested in getting any of them. They also have 30-day money-back guarantees on all of their plans, so there's no risk here in trying any of them. Granted, you ask for your refund refund before the 30th day. So that'll be it for this video. Thank you guys very much for watching. If you have any questions, please comment down below and like and subscribe if you'd like to stay up to date with more cybersecurity and VPN news. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one. Have a wonderful day.